Yo, why is it that the crackers are packed there with the honeys and the two brothers gotta carry the injured dude? I am so sorry. I never meant for any of this to happen.
I just want to get to a road, then I'm gonna whip your ass.
Jim, how you doing, baby?
I'm so cold. It hurts like a son of a gun.
How much further is the road past the house?
I don't know. A few miles?
A few miles? Are you kidding me?
Did you?
Shh.
I want to go home.
Oh. Oh. You are all a bunch of cowards! Is anybody home? Somebody help us! We need help!
Please stop. We shouldn't have gone this way. We need to turn around.
Go where? Back in the water?
Please, just stop. We need to stick together. We need to stop him.
Come on. You can't carry him all by yourself.
Baby, everything's gonna be all right. We don't need those zombies.
Those cowards!
Stop. We need to stick together.
Everything's gonna be just fine. We have the good Lord with us, baby. The good Lord will protect us.
So I first heard about this Hatchet movie from a friend of mine, Shailena, who taste I usually listen to, and she said, I didn't like that movie. It was too much of a comedy. And I thought, do we really need another funny horror movie? And don't get me wrong, I like my horror comedies when they're done well, but I don't need another like post-scream, like, here's the rules you can't break type of thing, because yeah, I'm pretty tired of those too. But I got this anyway because it's a slasher movie and I'm a sucker for those. I admit it. You know, I mean, any day that I could sit down and like watch like Mad Men and The Burning and all those horrible like early 80s slash movies. And this one is a total throwback. And yeah, it's funny. There's funny parts and there's little cameos. Tony Todd's in it. Robert Englund's in it. Kane Hodder plays the main like bad guy slasher killer. Victor Crowley is his name in this one, you know. And so, I mean, you get these great throwbacks to the slasher greats of yore. But I thought, you know, hey, where's the comedy? And there it is. And it said, though it did say on the box, eye-popping nudity. And everybody that watched this movie with me, they're like, you know, the nudity wasn't really that eye-popping, but the gore was plentiful. You got like heads getting ripped open. You had that dude from Office Space, the one that made the jump to conclusion mats. He gets his leg chomped on by an alligator. He gets killed gorily. Everybody, of course, there's just blood flying all over. It's the unrated cut, because that's the only way to go. Why they even bother releasing an R-rated cut? Does anybody buy the R-rated cut? I'm serious. If you're buying a movie called Hatchet, I'm guessing you probably know what you're in for. You're not going, you know, I'm going to get the R-rated version of Hatchet, or maybe I'll get the unrated version of Hatchet. And I haven't seen the R-rated version, so maybe it's way toned down, and maybe that's where all the eye-poppy nudity is. I don't know. Maybe I should run it sometime. But when I want it, I want freaking stuff going through people's heads. I want shovel decapitations. I want guts getting pulled out. I want mouths getting stretched open and heads broken and bodies getting thrown against trees. Jason in Part 7, you know, Friday 13th Part 7, where he picked up that guy in the sleeping bag and pounded him against the tree, because that's my favorite Friday 13th kill of all time. That's what I want to see. That's the unrated version. That's the version to get.